Inside leg kick from Tonner. Didn't see many kicks from the Aussie in the first. Jamie McEwig, his coach in the corner, giving him plenty of instructions between rounds. Nice thread through there from Tonner. Takes a kick to the groin, and referee Omari will call time. So will be a recovery period here for Josh Tonner. Up to 3 minutes allowed for recovery and medical examination for the Australian. Mitch, you've been exposed to some fabulous Muay Thai striking in the brilliant One Super Series. These left kicks, though, at Petchdam are on another planet.
Yeah, man, when you get these southpaw athletes that have been throwing that kick for most of their lives, they just get so precise at it. Look at the way he changes. You can't really tell where he's going with it. He has a nice little cock to his hip.
And look at Tonner coming forward, trying to barrage on the inside. There's a big right hand and a left hook from Tonner. Sticky left there. Oh, Tonner catches him with the right. And again, the tenacity. He backs him up with the right cross. Josh Tonner, house on fire here in the second round. And Petchdam with the knee. Tonner showing no respect to the Thai superstar. That's the nuggety crease. Oh, the roundhouse kick for Petchdam. The roundhouse kick for Petchdam. Tonner's down. He said he'd knock him out in the second. And he's done just that.
Check this out. Cocked. Boom. Oh, look at that. That it caught him with the knee and it hits him. Look at this. Take a look at it at a different angle. Oof. Yeah, it's right there. The knee caught him.
Petchdam of Thailand in the blue, Muay Thai world champion. Open up with the knees. You're already seeing the red knee on the right side of the body of Kudo, courtesy of the roundhouse kicks in the first round of Petchdam. Kudo is going to take Petchdam into the deepest water he's been in yet in One Super Series.
Maybe we have a new left highway coming up in Petchdam. Everything off the left side of this guy's body is just brilliant.
And he's going to try and get on the inside and work the overhand right. Petchdam in southpaw stance, so feeling our process so far, but that left leg is cocked and ready.
You can see his strategy. He's trying to inch forward. He's trying to apply that pressure. But, you know, he's kind of playing right into the strength of Petchdam. He's got to move.
Kenny on the inside after riding a couple of high left roundhouse kicks from Petchdam. And referee Olivia Kels breaks them. But already you're seeing the speed and the power on that favorite left kick. Here comes Kenny Tse. Rockets in the right hand. Jab two there from Kenny. Falls short.
This is what Kenny has to do. He has to keep applying that pressure because that's three now. Big left kicks.
You can see the game plan of C trying to counter off the left roundhouse kicks.
I'd like to see him start moving a little bit to the outside. Keep that foot constantly stepping out to the left because these are brutal.
Kenny gets on the inside again. Where's three left roundhouse kicks. Ties up Petchdam. Petchdam throws a knee. They tangle. And Olivia Kels breaks it. That left roundhouse kick of Petchdam is frightening. Kenny gets caught. He's out. This one's over.
A massive, look at this. Just, and then finished it off with the knee, and down he goes.
Rich, I was watching your facial expressions during that replay, and your eyebrows almost flew off your head. That is one of the greatest weapons in the combat sports world, isn't it? That left roundhouse.
I tell you what, if you didn't see it from the first kick that landed there, he was already out. And I think it was actually the knee that held him up from going down right there. Yeah. And then he's able to actually throw a third one. Interestingly enough, if you didn't pay attention, he did not throw, Petchdam did not throw any technique except for the leg kick.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.